Hello folks, welcome back to Epic Battle Fantasy 4. Well, let's not delay, let's get started. And we start with two instant deaths. I'm happy with that. Alright, we'll take down one of you. Or maybe not. This location is actually where some of the more annoying normal enemies actually start to occur. Not these guys aren't that annoying. But later on in this place there will be some really bad ones. Did I teach you? Yes, I did. Good thing I did. Doom has shown up quite a bit with this. And you know what? I'm gonna be a douchebag. Just cause I can. Sayonara, suckers. At this point in the game, it's where I start frequently checking my forge. See if I can upgrade any of my weapons. So, you may see me doing that a bit. Let's actually upgrade the Thunder Core. And we'll equip that to Lance. Because this area has a lot of enemies that are weak to this. Though unfortunately in doing this, there is also quite a few enemies that are, well, they absorb electricity, so. Yeah, let's upgrade your armor while we're at it too. Them mammoths. They're on a roll. It only has one. Oh well. So freeze, double damage, water, increased damage on thunder attacks. Let's see how much damage this does. That's not bad. I'm happy with that. More attack for you, more defense for you, and more magic defense. If you played Epic Battle Fantasy 3, you'll remember this dude at the back. This dude at the front, I don't recall being in the game, but he may very well have been. They both have instant kill attacks, I believe. The one at the back, his one is low accuracy. Like I said, I can't remember if this one here has an instant kill attack. So let's decrease their accuracy further before we do anything. That's not the instant kill attack. He pulls out this big kind of cannon. That's the instant kill attack. So I'm not gonna let him do that. Yeah, you're at least weak to war, so I'll do that. Yeah. That accessory we got increases bomb and stagger resistance. If we were just to get three of these, then we could just pop that on someone and be taking half damage from bomb attacks. Doom all across the board, par one dude. I really need to get Nat her one of our AoEs. Speaking of which, do we actually have the skill points? That's one thing I also need to check. Since we're starting to get a lot more AP, we should check our skills. So how much? 2,000? Hell yeah. We're not going to upgrade Arrow Rain for the most part. We've got it, that's enough to hit the status effects. So, yeah. Do more damage with that, and we'll upgrade her normal attack a couple times, and we'll save the rest. Matt, Cleaver, that's a must. Same with Swift Slash. You know, could have also possibly upgraded Protect. Yeah, could have actually. Nat. Pulsar, we're saving up for this. This is one of her few AoE spells, along with Thunderstorm, Ice Storm, and Firestorm. And also Star Shower. Every other spell is either single target or, you know, heals the party. Or a limit break. This is where she'll be getting most of her AoE spells, like Big Blast or something. Anyway, for our Lance, Siphon to increase the chances. Indeed, there's a battery over here. But we need to do a little bit of stuff with switches before we can even think about getting close to that. Doom stun. I love this bow. Now the only problem with getting Pulsar, if we just do this, there's a few enemies that resist or absorb dark, so that will be an issue. Right, now though I'm gonna take out this dude. Or not. I'm not complaining. That should be better. Jeez, that was pretty much half the battle destroyed by all my summons, like No Legs, Mammoth. The Gas Mask, one of my favourite items in this game for Lance. Doesn't even need to be placed on Lance, I could put it on Matt if I wanted for double the poison. Or even when Lance isn't in. And also it makes you resistant to poison element and poison itself. So yeah, we'll just put that on Lance just now. Like I said, I use him as a debuffer, so that is perfect for me. Let's get rid of the slimes and all that good stuff. And then we'll hit these guys with something different for once. Yeah, with this bow, I usually use Anna as a debuffer a lot more because any status ailment in the game, including death. Who doesn't want that? Alright. Summon for that big mother trucker at the back. Pretty much the same as the other slimes, just bigger, more HP. But has low evade, so. He can poison everyone though, unlike the others. Two instant deaths. It was on the wrong guy, but I don't care. What's done is done. Also, he was cursed, so he took even more damage from that than normal. Oh yeah, if he poisons himself, yeah. That was another thing, in Epic Battle Fantasy 3, foes weren't, oh, you just poisoned them further. Yeah, foes weren't just, okay, I'm gonna get more stats. They could enter the battle poisoned to heal themselves, but because poison didn't wear off in that game, the higher the number, the more the damage, they could heal permanently in the battle, unless you somehow got rid of that on them. So, yeah, Matt Rozak, he actually doesn't just go, okay, add a ton of health on or whatever. He does a lot of different things to make foes even tougher. These things here, I do not care if I don't scan them, I just want them dead. If I get a chance to scan them, okay then. But these things are so annoying. Things like that. And he can also do an attack which siphons the entire party. The entire party. For lots of turns. And it can spam it whenever it wants. So it's one of the first annoying enemies in the game. Or that, yeah. Thank you, Mammoth. Thank you. I'm happy. The Mammoth knows what's up. But yeah, with all the AP we're getting, might as well check. We're getting closer to that. Shall we upgrade this? No. We need Drain to get Unleash. We need to get Unleash, I think, for this. Yep. And then we'll get Legend. 9 hits. One of the strongest swords in the game counters with this ability. It's frequently used by a lot of the higher level players. So, yeah. And Pulsar. The spell as well for higher accuracy. Silver key, yeah, that's all nice and good. If the enemy isn't immune to dark, then yes. Well, shit. I'm not gonna risk it, I'll just bomb one of these dudes. Siphon doesn't affect their instant kill attack, I believe. It doesn't affect them, period. Weaken, siphon, wet. And he's weak to electricity. There's something I didn't know. There's the instant kill attack. Very low accuracy. If it hits, it's an instant kill, obviously, so glad that's a thing. That it's low accuracy. Okay. Milk, which we've got a lot of. And also, this can debuff enemies' magic attack as well, so. Yeah, pretty powerful. Especially when she's up at 70% extra attack power. And I do believe that's percent. The spacesuit randomly casts scan bot between turns. So if you're going into an area where you've not scanned anything, I suppose you could equip this. It's pretty defensive. I'll upgrade this just in case, I suppose. This thing's pretty easy to get up to max power because RAM chip, you know, things like this. easily found in this area. Oh yeah, I forgot about the bowling ball. Sorry, Cat Badge. You'll go on Matt instead then. Before we face this mini boss here, alright, we'll just go get this chest since we saw it back there. You see, don't underestimate the mammoth and whatnot in the game because, yeah, half the battle was taken out. Yep, we can unlock this and get the Ultra Zapper. Drains MP from targets with certain skills. May cast Solar Flare with certain skills. And it's non-element and lets Lance resist the three main elements. So drains MP. So if he was just to attack, he could get more MP to do more debuffing and other buffing stuff and everything. And he resists the three main elements. So that's already pretty nice as well. Solar Flare makes it, I'm pretty sure we don't have that just yet. Oh no, we do. Here it is, Solar Flare. Debuffs all foes' accuracy. So I don't even need to teach this to him. As long as he has that equipped, he can randomly do it. So I could actually teach Solar Flare like to Nats, for example, or Anna, if she can learn it. No, she can't. Yeah, it's just, I could teach it to Nats and Lance doesn't actually need it at that point. But yeah, door's closed? Eh, don't care. Back in we go. Right, this mini boss. This, I believe, is called the Guardian. Now we'll scan it with Matt. I call it a mini boss because you only see it like two places in this this place. It's immune to death, which usually bosses or mini bosses are. So, yeah, and also it's got a high debuff resistance to everything. That's why I consider it a mini boss, because usually normal enemies aren't resistant like that, unless of course it's a boss. So, yeah, you are immune to freeze. I can at least freeze the other two, or not. Yeah, you can also do a high amount of damage. We're getting hit hard like that. The defense went up from the bowling ball. Yeah, I need to actually switch to her. The defense went up from the bowling ball, and the magic attack went up from the red dress. Anyway, let's, I suppose, buff our magic attack a bit further. Let's switch to his electric weapon. And it gets stunned as soon as we go ahead and, you know. It's just typical. We'll use temper before we do that. There is one skill I should get for Anna, and pretty soon, as enemies will start doing a lot of damage. Let's just end it. The skill in question we need this for. Reflex. Buffs the evade. I'm gonna get protect first for when we do get hit. But reflex will be our next priority. Let's buff his normal attack. Let's get that up. Yeah, barrier would also be another good choice. I'm gonna switch Matt back to the Holy Sword, because this enemy here, he absorbs thunder, so not a good thing. Yeah, let's just keep doing this. Oh hey, we've got free reign now. It's a three wave battle, so let's buff while these guys are stunned for four turns. Yeah, let's have these two just do that. And do that. And because they both died as the wave is switching, no extra damage. Of course you would stun Naps, huh? Anyway, we need to scan this dude in the middle. Absorbs dark and poison and water. 70% resistant to stun and freeze, but he has an extra susceptibility to death. That's one of the few enemies I think that is extra susceptible to death. I don't recall any other enemy being like that. Also, yeah, Mammoth does extra damage to it. Oh, you poisoned it. That's the one bad thing with this bow. You can occasionally give the enemy an actual buff. Electricity. and hope this hits. Instant death. We can't get this until we get the ladder from very late on in the game. And here's the second guardian. There's two of them in this fight. We don't need to do this battle just yet. When we've swung around this way and picked up another battery, then we'll need to face him to get this one to then proceed further into this place. And through that door, it's so close now, lies the boss, the Praetorian. And another new enemy. Suppose we'll have Matt scan. These guys are weak to Earth. You know what? Let's do it. Let's see the mighty Oak in action. See if you can actually do something. No. See, even against enemies that are weak to Earth, bearing in mind that obviously it's not powered up, it's still absolutely pathetically weak. So I would never really recommend using the Mighty Oak. Just die. The lesser of you that live in this world, the better. Yeah, it can dispel your buffs as well. That's how bad that thing is. I'm kind of leaving this guy to last for two reasons. One, he isn't that big a threat, and I'm looking to see his charge attack. We'll do combo shot on you. Are you going to attempt to charge? No? Mammoth! Okay, I shouldn't have attacked him. If I was wanting to show his attack, I shouldn't have attacked him. Extra health will put on that, so that's always helpful. Oh, the jellyfish. Great. Like I said, these things absorb electricity. So they're one of the few enemies in this dungeon. The man before, he said they're all either weak to electricity or bomb, or most of them. This is the one guy that says nope. I believe there's another one as well. They're weak to poison though. instant death. A lot of people don't really like this bow for whatever reason, but I do not see why. It's helped me out in more sticky situations than any other weapon. Of course, later on I do switch out for something that actually can help her do damage, but this bow does such a good job. If there's an enemy that's hampered by every buff in the game, yeah, just slap that bow on and debuff him to hell and back. The only downside to the bow is it doesn't give you any offensive stats, but that's not the power of the bow. The main power of the bow comes from the fact that she can hit every enemy 3 times, and inflict 3 random status ailments on them. Plus, a lie, it does give magic, but she's not really that good on magic, and it increases her resistance to siphon as well. So, oh, and look, I told you it's one of the first weapons you'll get up to level 5. Flare's only got up to level 3, so don't need to worry about that. Anyway, Reflex, up to level 2, no problem. Your magic, your physical. Kyun to get more stat buffs. And Siphon is just so good. This place will take more than 2 episodes to go through, so. Can use Pulsar here with no problem. The attack that we got for Matt was a limit break, so he can't exactly use it just yet. Debility. I've been looking out for this ability. Lance. This is where shit starts to get real with Lance and Matt, and where I start bringing in Lance a bit more. For the sheer fact that, oh yeah, we got the water ones are here as well. But yeah, for the sheer fact that Lance, he can debuff enemies' defense now, and Matt can increase his attack. I have had it where the final boss in one of the forms, I was able to debuff the boss's defense. And then to combo, I had Matt up at max attack, you know, with the buff and with the extra crits. His cleaver, or cleave, took the boss from full health and killed it instantly. That's how debilitating that combo can be. And this is when I wasn't using Anna too much. And even better, it was when I was at college, playing this on the web browser. So my friend even saw it. I believe I was like on normal difficulty or something. And I wasn't too overleveled, I don't think. I might have been, but so yeah, I normally use debility a lot when it comes to Lance and Matt on the team. Oh yeah, the grass ones also appear here. Well, poison ones, but... they look like grass to me. Well, earthen ones, since there's an earth element but not a grass one. Yeah, green jelly. It's weak to poison. Yeah, it uses poison attacks. That's something I don't get. Maybe because it's a jellyfish, it's weak to it. Let's fully heal up here and then face the jellyfish. Instant death on the wrong guys, of course. Let's see. Oh dear, that must have hurt. There we go. With you doing three attacks on all enemies, it seems death appears quite a bit. The three random elements are across all enemies, obviously. So if one enemy gets weakened on the first attack, then all of them could get weakened. It isn't three random status ailments for each enemy. So, yeah. That prevents us, I suppose, from being too overpowered, but even then, that means if you get death on one enemy, any other enemy could also be inflicted with that. We've almost got one of the more powerful swords set up to max as well. We just need seven more of these bubble stones. And I'm also going to equip... I'm going to also upgrade this. The evade could be useful. We'll be taking this off Anna very soon. In fact, after this dungeon, because there's something I'm going to get that pretty much requires you have that to prevent lots of extra damage on you. This door here is actually very damn crucial for something later on. If you don't have it open, you're going to be trapped in an area until you open up the door. You'll see what I mean when we get towards the end of the game. And we may as well go get that chest. I can't remember, I think it might have a summon. Either that or it's a limit break. I think it actually might be a limit break. No, it's a staff. Oh, I missed you. Yeah, you kind of ran out of luck, mate. There's the slime effect. This is a very rare stats effect, but it means that character can never take a turn, cannot catch items, and greatly reduces your stats. No cure exists except death or time. And of course only slimes can inflict that status effect. That is the stats effect that was added in actually when the Steam version was released and the game was updated. You're on Congregate and everything. It's rare, but it's one of the more debilitating effects in the game. Because you cannot cure it. The Thunder Elementals. Right. These guys are weak to dark. I remember that. Yep, dark, poison, and earth. They can also put regen on themselves. Yep. Anyone who's played Pokemon will know that reference. Once we crack this door, we'll actually end off the episode. Siphon actually stops those fire elementals from doing much damage. That's interesting. Can you take them out? All but one, because he was in defend. Yes, they put themselves in defend and give themselves regen for 5 turns. There isn't actually a confusion status ailment in this game, so they obviously weren't referencing anything in the game itself. Of course you would have to. This room is actually where I grind AP a bit if I'm underleveled. Oh, if we get a plutonium core, which we will get a guaranteed one from the boss, we can upgrade this to max. Not bad. This is also the same, plutonium core. Yeah, do it. This also replaces weapon status effect with stagger. So if you're wanting to stagger enemies, this flare is for you. Tinfoil hat. Do 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 do. Yeah. And I'm aware we haven't staggered these enemies, but just want to get rid of these dudes here. They aren't that dangerous. Well, unlike the ice ones, but. See? The other enemy that's absorbing electricity and half damage from bombs. Though they are a bit more resistant to that instant death. He was dreaming about Nax. But yeah, tired decreases your accuracy and your evade. That fire sprite, he just hurt the two elementals down here. Because, yeah, they don't absorb fire and instant death. Yeah, we'll do this to hurt these guys. Don't keep attacking them, come on. This is why I powered this up. Full heal. It doesn't really need to be powered up past 6, unless you're a completionist. That's his charge attack. All the mammoths. The mammoth train. Ice Age has come along. I mean, come on, that was 2 mammoths. Where else will you see 2 mammoths? Yeah, let's get Reflex up. Cleaver? I think it was Cleave back in Epic Battle Fantasy 3, and that's why I keep calling it that instead of Cleaver. Yeah. We need this to get Judgment, so I'm actually going to get this. And then one of the most powerful holy magics in the game. Genesis. This is a bit different to the Diamond Golem's Genesis. As you noticed, he went into auto-defend along with all his allies. For us, it either revives or gives auto-revive status to all allies. So it is different, and I don't think it could weaken us for the Diamond Golem either. So there is a few differences between our one and his one. The higher the debilitate, the more defense is taken away. This one, I'm actually going to bring in Lance. Now there's a big reason for that. Oh yeah, first we need to push that. Let's grab this as well. There's Ion Cannon. I knew it was in here somewhere. That was Lance's limit break back in Epic Battle Fantasy 3. Alright, debilitate. They affected both of them? Really? Alright. I'm going to Kion. Mostly for the stat boost. It was also a full heal if we'd been hurt. And then I'm going to use Temper on Matt to give him Brave and max attack. Sick. 7,000. Lance, debilitate them one more time. Alright. Heal us up. Let's see how much damage. $11,000 per hit. That is not too shabby. If we can get our limit breaks back before the boss of this area, that's gonna be about 55,000 damage, assuming we're at the same strength. Just think of how much health that is. That would have been half of the Diamond Golem's health on Epic Difficulty, because he had 100,000 then, something like that. Half of his health. And if when we were using the war one, I would have done even more damage. So, yeah. That is insane. That's the debilitate, limit break, max attack combo. And last one. Anyway, we'll go through this door next episode. But before we end off, let's take a look at our skills one last time. Anything else I would like? If the enemy buffs himself, I suppose. I suppose we'll buff Legend up a bit. We'll pick up Rapture. And we'll upgrade, actually no. Yes, that can dispel the target as well. Single target and it's actually does damage, so. Any stat buffing items? No. Forge, one last time. Oh yeah, the lightning badge. Ah, I need a topaz. Yeah, that, once we've upgraded it up once, will make anyone who wears it immune to stun, and that's nice. But yeah, this has been Scottish Boy 112, signing out. In the next episode, the rest of the waste disposal plant and the Praetorian, and maybe the Praetorian Mark 2. See you all next time.